Hello friends, welcome to the e-learning platform, an initiative by Science Park, Savitribai Phule, Pune University. Today we will cover chapter 24th and chapter 12th from standard 5th. And the title of the session is Substances, Objects and Energy. My name is Dr. Supriya and let's start our session. Now, let's cover some very interesting subtopics in this video. First, we'll see what are substances. Then we'll see what are particles. Then we'll get to know different states of substances. And finally, we will cover substances which are used to make different objects. Now here, what do you see here? Someone is writing something on a blackboard. What do we use to write on a blackboard? Yes, we use a chalk. So chalk is made up of calcium carbonate. So when you write with a chalk on a blackboard for a long time, what do you observe? You observe that the chalk is becoming smaller and smaller. The more you use chalk, more its size reduces. Can you tell me why this happens? Or have you seen someone cutting a wood here? So all the substances that we see around us are made up of very tiny particles. How? Let's observe this man who is cutting a huge wood here. Now what is he doing? You must have seen some sawdust or particles which are flying all over when he is cutting that wood, right? So from this movie, you will understand that wood is made up of tiny little particles. Likewise, we always use mixer in our house. Why do we use mixer grinder? Yes, to grind something, right? We put ground nuts in that and we get a powder of groundnut. So let's see what exactly happens when we provide electricity to the mixer grinder. The blades, which are very short here at the bottom of the mixer, starts rotating. Now here there is a motor which converts electricity into a motion, a mechanical energy. There is a coil which is placed between the magnetic field. Now when a current flows through that field, the coil experiences a magnetic force which causes action of rotation. And when the blades rotate fast, whatever is there in this container gets chopped off and we get a very tiny particles of that substance. Now you can try this on your own at home. Please think about it and let's talk about it when we meet at the discussion period. Now what you have to do, take few ground nuts or few sugar crystals and or anything which is eatable, grains or pulses, or you can take chalk and pound them on a pestle and a mortar. Gharat khalbatta suna? Sabke ghar mein ye rehta hai, jisme aap उसको खलते हैं, हम उसको खलबत्ता बोलते हैं. So you have to observe closely what happens there when you are pounding anything in that and tell your observation at the time of discussion. Okay. Now I said there are particles. Particles. So what are these particles? Let's get to know about these particles. Now, have you ever seen that when any metal like iron, aluminium or copper, when they smooth the surface of the metal with a file, we get particles of iron or copper or aluminium of that metal particularly. So that particular thing is called as particle. All the substances like pencil, chalk, paper, wood, wheat grains, iron, copper, coal, everything which you see around you, all are made up of very fine particles. Small particles of various substances are made up of many tinier particles. Okay. Now you have to tell me, you have to really think hard and tell me the answer. You can write down all your answers in your notebook of Science Park, and then you can discuss it with me. What are the small particles that can be seen in a beam of light that enters a room? I'm repeating my question. What are the small tiny particles that you can see in a beam of light that enters in a room? Let's get to know this more by looking at this picture. Now here, this girl is experiencing some particles here in the ray of light. You have to tell me what are they exactly. Experience this in your daily life chores and then let's discuss about it. Okay. Now, in 6th century, Rishi Karnad stated, who was an ancient Indian natural scientist, we used to call him Rishis, and a philosopher, who founded the Vaisheshika school of Indian philosophy. He started this school. And this also represents earlier Indian physics. So all the earlier Indian physics was written by Rishi Karnad. Now Rishi Karnad was a Maharshi, was born in 6th century before Christ at Prabhas Kshetra near Sorti Somnath, which is in state of Gujarat. And he was given a name earlier, Uluk. Okay. He proposed that all things in the world can be classified into 7 categories. He was also the first one to suggest that every object in the universe is made up of minute particles. He named that tiny particles Philov. Now, as we have seen, we got to know what are particles. There are different states of matter. Matter is always and always made up of tiny little particles. All the substances exist in 3 states, namely solid, liquid, and gas. Different states of matter are due to different arrangement of particles of that matter. Now in solid state, particles of matter are very close to each other and hold each other really tightly. That is, there is a strong force of attraction between them. As a result, solids have definite shape and volume. Particles in liquid are much farther apart than the particles in solids. And therefore, force of attraction in liquids is weaker than solids. Liquids have definite volume, but they do not have definite shape. So you pour water from one shape to another shaped bottle, the water takes the shape of that bottle, right? We always observe this. So liquids have definite volume, but they do not have definite shape. In gases, the particles of matter are very far away from each other, and so force of attraction is very weak. Thus, gases neither have definite shape nor volume. So they can fill entire space or volume of the container, irrespective of the container size. Now let's see different states of matter. Let's take an example of ice. So ice is in the solid form, water is the liquid form, and steam is the gaseous form of that. Now can we convert solid into liquid and liquid into gas? That is ice into water and water into ice? Yes, we can do so. And we also know that we can convert liquid water into steam and reverse back to liquid water. By what is exactly matters to change the state of that liquid of water? Think about it. Yes, you can change the state of matter by heating or by cooling. So every substance in our surrounding is found either in solid, liquid, or gaseous state. By which process do we do the conversion from solid to liquid? By melting the solid. And by vaporization, we do from liquid to gas. And there are reverse methods like condensation and solidification. Now this is the cycle which you really is important for you to remember. A solid can be directly get converted into gas. Remember this. Gas can be converted into liquid. Liquid can be converted into solid and vice versa. So you can convert any state of matter into another state of matter. Now here I am showing you the different states at particle level. So as we have seen here in earlier slides, in earlier thing, that solids have definite arrangement. So they have definite volume and shape. But in case of liquids, particles do not have definite shape. So they fill the container completely. They have definite volume but not the shape. In case of gases, like we have gaseous water in clouds, they fill everywhere, right? So that is the comparison of phases at particle level. Now again, think really hard and answer my question. My question is, do you know any substance which doesn't obey this rule of transformation of phases, that any substance needs to transform from solid to liquid and then liquid to gas? Do you know any substance which directly converts from solid to gas? Tell me. Think about it and answer my question. And the second question is, list substances which we use only in their solid state. Okay? You have to write down all your answers in your Science Park notebook. Now, let's see different objects or substances of different objects. Now here I have shown you a picture of different objects of which are made up of soil, earthen objects, right? So how many different types of earthen objects do we use and see when we go to a shop? We see different types and shapes of different bottles, tea mugs, coffee mugs. We see earthen pots, different sizes, different shapes, right? We take so many decorative objects which are made up from soil. We from ancient India, like from thousands of years, we always store water in earthen pot, especially in summers. Right? So we can make different objects from same substance. Now, since now you know that we can form different objects from the same substance, look around you closely and list such substances around you which are used to make different objects. Okay? Thank you. Were you bored with this? If not, please list all the write down all your answers and let's meet at the discussion period on next Monday. Bye bye.